says Lord North, Sashriyakal, Vanakkam, Namaste. We are in Singapore and at the Armageddon booth. Now, some of you back home might be asking, what is Armageddon? We have never heard of it. With us, we have the lovely Wanda. And hello, welcome to the show.
Hi.
Wanda's here. She's the product manager for Armageddon. So first off, what is Armageddon?
Armageddon's a gaming peripherals brand. We have headsets, mice, speakers, basically every kind of peripheral the gamers would need. So we've only been around for about 1 year. It's a Singaporean brand name.
And you're basically a Singapore-based company, right? So you're in Singapore, by Singapore, for Singapore currently.
Yes, that's right. We are a product of Singapore. The brand is Singapore. The mother company is Singaporean.
Excellent. What's your view on the gaming products? Now, there's a lot of people out there in the world who are people like Razer, people like Cooler Master, who are going and saying gaming hardware is becoming smaller and smaller. But there are other people out there who are going and saying gaming hardware is bigger and bigger. What's Armageddon's view on this?
I really think it's what market you're talking about, because in terms of casual gamers, there are a lot more casual gamers now. In terms of competitive gamers, because the competitive scene is really difficult, it's hard being a competitive team. So, well, that's partially why we're having the tournament. But when they say it's getting smaller, I think they probably mean just the competitive gamers right up there. But in general, in terms of like casual gamers, especially let's say even in India, a lot of the developing countries in this area, it's definitely growing.
Right, well, that is something which we all want to go talk about, right? So the base is becoming bigger, the top is becoming also, and that's how you want to go ahead and do this. Now, as far as Armageddon goes, what's so special about Armageddon products?
I think in developing the products, we've taken into account not just what the competitive gamers want, but also what the casual gamers want. So we do have mice targeted at both segments, but besides that, a lot of the costing, when it comes to price, we don't do it at a price where we think, okay, you'll buy it at this price, but we do it at a price where we think it's reasonable for such a product. If it's a simple product, it goes at a simple price.
Yeah, well, I heard there's a mouse you're selling for $39, right?
Yes, $39 for a gaming mouse, macro programmable. It's a very simple structure that a lot of the competitive gamers go for, but I really think there's no need to charge excessively for something that's really a very simple product.
For all of you back home, that $40 translates to about 1600 rupees. Now, 1600 rupees for a gaming mouse, which is in the market close to 4000, that's what I'm talking about, competitive price advantage. And these are good products. We were checking some of them out. They're really good to use. They're really well made.
Thank you.
You guys have been doing a great job. So tell us about the teams that are here. Tell us about the tournament. Tell us about being at the IT show.
Okay. First up, for this tournament, it is meant only for teams which do not have sponsorships. So this is kind of like a semi-pro tournament. Why we are doing this is because we find that even though there's a lot of viewership for matches where it's both competitive teams playing, a lot of these semi-pro teams are being neglected. Like, they're trying to find the opportunities to them, like, you know, $5,000 is a lot of money and can support them for an entire year or year and a half. So what we're trying to do is address this segment and try to groom these teams so that they can then compete later on with the super pro teams, because what they really lack is just opportunity. So what we've done here is that we've had qualifiers in each one of the countries, including Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, Vietnam, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, and we had an online qualifier for the rest of Asia. Unfortunately, our two Indian teams couldn't make it because I think one, there was a natural disaster in one of the places, and then the other team couldn't make it because of financial difficulties, even though we wanted to reimburse their airfare and recovering their lodging here as well. So I'm not too sure exactly what the difficulties were, but it's really sad that they couldn't make it. But yeah, right here in the finals, we have three teams. Team ABC from Malaysia, we have Team Awake from Thailand, as well as Team First Departure from Singapore. So wish them the best of luck.
Well, yeah, we are all wishing all the three best of luck, and it is sad that the Indian teams could not come here. We really wish they could, but that's okay. C'est la vie, maybe next time. What's your view on taking this product across Asia? Now, you are an Asian company, and you're now branching out across Southeast Asia. How far in Asia? Are you going towards Dubai? Are you going towards Australia? What's the big...
Actually, the plan right now is that because we are a lot more stable in Southeast Asia, the next place we're headed to is actually Moscow for our Moscow show. Hopefully over there we can expand into Eastern Europe as well. But it doesn't mean that we're going to neglect the rest of Asia's market, because the market here is really very big and a lot of the markets are really suited for the category in which we belong in. So yeah, for sure, we're still looking at Asia, but the next step for now, in about later part of the year, about 2 or 3 months from now, is to go into Eastern Europe.
Oh, we all hope that the lovely Wanda and Armageddon come down to India and come to our shows and go ahead and bring Armageddon products to India, because I think all of you are really excited to go ahead and check them out. If you have friends and family, tell them to go to Armageddon's website. It's down below. You can go ahead and order things online, right?
At this point in time, the e-store is not up yet, but it will be soon.
Well, it'll be soon, and that's the time to go ahead and start ordering these products. If you have friends and family in Singapore, that's the thing to go ahead and do. Wanda, thank you so much for being on the show. It's been a pleasure.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much for interviewing.
Thank you. Take care. Cheers. Bye-bye. See you next time.